families compete to name the most popular responses to a survey of some simple questions. The answers are locked into our game board and every point is worth 50 Rand. In round 3 and 4, the points are doubled and then tripled in round 5. The family with the most points at the end of round 5 play for a jackpot of 75,000 Rand. South Africa, it's time to play Family Feud. Give it up for Steve Harvey.
How y'all doing? Welcome to the show. How y'all doing? Welcome to the show. Thank y'all. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. Thank y'all very much. Well, welcome to Family Feud, South Africa, everybody. I'm your man, Steve Harvey. Well, this is the second season. We're excited to be back. Well, hard to come back when you're just home again, right? So good to be here. Thank you for having me. Thank you for loving my family when we are here. Thank you for your hospitality. But I come to give South Africa a good time, baby. Yeah. So welcome to the show. Let me tell you how this is how the game works, everybody. Our researchers have been out on the streets of Mzansi. We've been asking you some answers to some really, really simple questions. Now, the answers are locked into the game board up here. The family that accumulates the most points at the end of this game has a chance to walk away with some serious money, play for the jackpot of 75,000 Rand. Well, let's go meet the families, everybody. From Moot, it's the Masilo family. Playing against from Boksburg, it's the Skeepers family. So everybody ready to get the show started? Say yeah. Yeah. All right, let's go. Give me Tamiso, give me Natalie. Ladies, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Steve.
Okay. Top 8 answers on the board. This is a fill in the blank. People who have lots of children must be what?
Loving.
Loving. Natalie?
Well, Steve, I know someone right here that has a lot of kids, and I think they must be very wealthy. Very wealthy.
Who
just saying, you know.
Who are you talking about?
Well, Steve, I'm just saying, you know. I'm just saying and looking, you know.
Well, them are all your kids over there?
Half of them.
Okay. Wealthy.
Yes. 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 That's it.
That's wealthy. A play.
You play?
Yeah, come. Yeah. Okay, so y'all got the South African flags on and everything. Y'all just going for it.
Oh,
what
yeah.
do you do, Natalie?
Well, I'm like you, I'm self-employed.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Okay. Now, the what you do is a secret. She doesn't want to share that with us today. So we'll just move on. Why don't you introduce everybody?
Thank you, Steve. This is my nephew, Torin. Next to him is my favorite daughter, Kirsty, and my niece, Savannah. And next to Savannah is my favorite son, Kyle. Skeepers family from Boksburg.
So you have 2 children?
Yes, I do.
Yes. Because if you call her your favorite daughter and there's another one at home, this is not gonna be, this really is gonna be Family Feud. All right, let's go. Taryn, how you doing, man?
I'm good, and you, Uncle Steve?
What do you do?
I'm a data scientist in telecoms.
Oh, a data scientist.
Data scientist.
Yeah. They let you have that haircut as a scientist?
Yeah, I work behind the scenes. They don't really see
you. Oh, they don't really see you? No. Oh, they just care about your brain.
That's all that matters.
Oh, okay. If you was out front.
Maybe I'd be.
Yeah, you'd have to get a haircut, yeah. All right, let's go, man. Fill in the blank. People who have lots of children must be what?
Dealing with all those little ones running around, I think it requires a lot of patience.
Patience!
Yeah, he's on the ball.
Yes. Christy, how are you doing?
I'm good, thanks, and you, Steve?
Good, what do you do?
I'm a first-year university student.
Okay, what are you studying?
Psychology.
Psychology, yes. Oh, that's pretty good.
Yeah.
A doctor?
Yeah, no, for the mind, yes.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's good. Mm-hmm. I took psychology in school.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, didn't work. Everybody thought I was crazy, so I had to get out of class. Here we go. People who have lots of children must be what?
Supportive, Steve.
Supportive. Savannah, how are
you? I'm well, and you?
Uncle Good. Steve. What do you do?
A lot.
A lot?
I am a student, and I work as a service advisor.
Service advisor?
Yes.
Okay, good. Well, let's play. People who have lots of children must be what?
In this day and age, I would like to think open-minded, because people have a lot of their own feelings.
Open-minded. Open-minded. Kyle, how you doing?
Fine, thanks, and you, Steve?
Good, what do you do?
I'm a multimedia designer, but I'm a student.
Okay, how old are you, man?
I am 23.
Oh, you're young, yeah. And how old are you, Christy?
I'm 19. Today, yes.
Today is your birthday?
Yes.
Really? Well, now, Christy, wouldn't this be the birthday gift of all birthday gifts?
Yeah.
Is if you win today and walk out of here with 75,000 rand?
Yes, I'm gonna be smiling. Yeah. Yep, that's the plan.
Well, we'll see how it goes. Good luck to you. Kyle, let's go, man. One strike. People who have lots of children must be what?
Stressed.
Stressed. That should have been number one. Stressed. Natalie, people who have lots of children must be what?
Stupid, Steve.
Well. Find out something new about yourself every day, don't you? Stupid! I just want to point out there is a difference between stupid and crazy. I'm crazy. But I have lots of children, so according to Natalie, I must be stupid too. But I'm number one. Okay. Taryn, we only got one strike, man. Fill in the blank. People got lots of children must be what?
Again, cleaning up after all these little ones must make you very tired.
All day tired. I'm telling you, now tired should be up there. Obviously, see, they didn't ask people who had children. They just asked 100 people. If you have 7 children, you are tired. Period. All my children are grown. All of them. I'm tired of all of them. Christy, we got 2 strikes. We got to be careful. Masilo family can steal.
Yes.
People who have lots of children must be what?
Probably strict.
Strict! All right, family, here we go. People who have lots of children must be what?
Have a big house.
Okay, let's go. Yeah, it should be there.
They have a big house.
That's a good answer.
Number seven.
What's up?
See, they talk to somebody that don't have kids. Six.
Constantly broke.
Well, we got a game, folks. Masilo family not on the board. SKEEPERS family got 77. Hey, folks, don't go away. We're playing Family Feud. We'll be right back. Family Feud, everybody. Masilo family not on the board. SKEEPERS family 77. Give me Sylvia. Give me Terry. All right, guys. Pronounce your name.
Taryn.
Oh, Taryn.
Yep, there we
go. I said Taryn.
Yeah.
Taryn. Taryn. All right, brother. Top seven answers on the board. Name a milestone people achieve that they can be proud of.
Achieving a degree.
A degree, yeah.
Yes.
We're gonna play.
We're gonna play. All right, Christy, give me a milestone people achieve they can be proud of.
It's Kirsty, Steve. It's Kirsty.
Well, you had your braids over half the time. See, here you go. See, here you go. See, now I can, these names right here are very simple. But if you have your hair over the name, then I have to start pulling up what I think your name is. So I was saying Christy, but it's actually Kirsty. Rhymes with thirsty. Name a milestone people achieve they can be proud of.
Getting their dream job.
A dream job. Savannah.
Yes.
Name a milestone people achieve they can be proud of.
And one day I'm gonna have this, buying my first car. Yeah.
You're young, so do you know I didn't own my first automobile that I could buy till I was 38 years old.
Wow.
Whew. I don't want to wait
that long.
That
was my first time I could buy a car in my name. My father had given me a car. First car I bought, I was 38.
Yep. Now you have a lot.
Oh, I got a couple cars now. I got a couple of them now. Buy a car. Kyle, give me a milestone people achieve they can be proud of.
Well, one day, I would like to be a homeowner.
Yep. Yeah, man. Yeah, man. Yeah. Guess how old I was when I bought my first house. Now, I bought my car at 38. I'm gonna show you how God worked. How old was I when I bought my first house? I bought the car first, I'll just tell you that.
I'm gonna say 45.
39, baby. Right up, bam, bam! Bam, bam! Here come God, look at him work. Bam, bam, just like that. 38, 39. Buy a home. Miss Natalie.
Steve, I'll say a milestone birthday, whether it's 21st or 30th or 40th, milestone birthday.
She got these two kids and she the boss. And she been running things since she been here. She started up here. When she came up here, she was telling me what to do there. Someone up here has a lot of kids. She been doing this since she got here. You know, she made the jackets they got on.
Yep,
she did. I already know.
Oh, I didn't know that.
I know how this goes. Folks, I know how to read people. She'll need these questions. Steve, a milestone. You're supposed to wait till I ask the question. I made the jackets. I don't have to wait. These jackets are beautiful. She made the jacket. Kyle didn't want to wear the jacket.
I look cool.
No, you look cool, but Kyle did not want the jacket.
It's true.
He didn't want to wear the jacket. Kyle says, Mom, I'm too big for this. They look like pajamas. Shut up, you're wearing the jacket. Kirsty. Kirsty says something to the other kids about the jacket, but they knew they couldn't vote Mama out.
That's very true.
Because she the captain of the team. I know her. Ain't none of these kids thought of this jacket. This is her idea. We're going to wear matching jackets.
Yes.
All the kids went, I'll be damned. Yeah. On TV, mother, I want to look cool on TV. No. then, now hold on, check this out. Then she made him and Kyle wear the red shirts.
Yep, yep.
And made the girls get the yellow shirts. This was going bad, so bad. But she insisted.
That's my mother.
Because she is bossy. And she bossy me. She talking to me like she made me a jacket. So how long did it take you?
How did you know? How long? I didn't make them, but I had them made.
They not on the rack at the store.
No, they not.
Nobody has a flag coat. You ever been in the mall and went, excuse me? Can I help you? Yes. You have any flag coats? Excuse me? Flag coats. For you? No. For the entire family.
All of us. All of us.
But I want the material to be white so the flags pop. So who did you get to make the flag jackets?
Someone that runs a small business that's also self-employed.
Oh, okay. Yes. So you were supporting small business.
Yes, I commissioned it, yes.
Yes. It's always good to support small business. Y'all hanging in there. You know, when you go back to the university, your friends are going to see this on TV.
I look forward to it.
Yeah, huh?
I look forward to it.
No, you don't.
Patriotic.
Patriotic.
Yes. Proud South African.
Oh, you should be. Yeah, you should be proud to be South African. Natalie, name a milestone people achieved that they can be proud of.
The answer is a milestone birthday.
A milestone birthday. Yeah. All right, my man, we got no strikes. We're rolling. Give me a milestone people can achieve they can be proud of.
So at 27, you're at that age where you need to think about long-term, and one of those long-term milestones is getting married.
Oh, wow.
Getting married. So let me ask you something, man. Are you thinking about it?
Yes, I'm working towards it.
Well, I mean, you got somebody in mind?
Definitely.
Oh, okay. Mm. Yeah, she pretty fine.
Oh, she's a 12.
A 12. Go to work, boy.
Definitely.
Go to work,
definitely.
Boy.
What's a 12?
She a 12.
12.
Kirsty, we got no strikes. We're just rolling. Name a milestone people achieve they can be proud of.
I think achieving a certain level of wealth that they can be proud of.
A certain level of wealth.
Oh, yay.
That's only one strike. Savannah.
Yes.
Name a milestone people achieve they can be proud of.
Having kids. One day.
Yes. Having children.
They don't want them.
Wow. All right, man, we got two strikes, Kyle. We got to be careful now. Masilo family can steal. Give me a milestone people achieve they can be proud of.
Well, one day, I would like to have no debt.
Yes.
about his child.
That's not gonna happen. Debt is okay. OPM, other people's money, is how you get rich. You use other people's money, not yours. That's how you get rich. No debt!
Oh. Come on, guys.
All right, guys. Name a milestone people achieved that they can be proud of.
Going on an international trip.
Going on an international trip. Number five.
Anniversary.
Well, that was round two, everybody. Masilo family still not on the board. Skeepers family got 156. You got a long way to go. You're still fine. Don't worry about it. You're playing well. Don't go away, y'all. We'll be right back. We got two good families. We're gonna double the points. Family Feud. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. Let's look at it. We got the Masilo family not on the board. We got the Skeepers family, 156. Yeah. Yeah. Give me Refill Wade, give me Kirsty. Yeah. Pronounce your name.
Refill Wade.
That's what I said, yeah. Refill Wade. I just went with it real slow. I saw refill, went with that. And then I know over here, W-E is not we, it's we.
Yeah, well done, yeah. Steve.
I learned that last time I was here. I'm getting better at it. Kirsty.
Thank you.
In this round, we're gonna double the points. You ready, ladies?
Ready.
We've got the top six answers on the board. If you were visiting a foreign country for the first time, name something you'd be worried about. Refueling.
Rate of exchange, money.
Oh, the rate of exchange.
Well done, Sophie.
Woo-hoo. Yeah. Kirsty.
Not knowing the language.
Not knowing the language.
Yes. 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 Yes.
Oh, we yeah, we're gonna play. Come on.
Jimmy.
Savannah, visiting a foreign country for the first time, name something you'd be worried about.
This has happened to me. Sir, my passport going missing.
The passport going missing.
Yes.
Oh. It's okay.
It's okay, it's fine.
If you if you were visiting a foreign country for the first time, mm-hmm. name something you'd be worried about.
I would be worried about getting lost.
Yep. Getting lost. Miss Natalie, ma'am, only one strike. If you were visiting a foreign country for the first time, name something you'd be worried about.
Steve, it's definitely border control. Immigration.
Mm-hmm. Border control. Immigration. Aww. All right, we got two strikes now. We need to be careful. Masilo family could steal. If you were visiting a foreign country for the first time, T, name something you'd be worried about.
Some countries you have to be very careful with what you eat. So I'm gonna say worried about the food.
Wow. Yeah. Worried about the food. Yes. Yes. Oh, right back to you, sweetheart. Now we got two strikes. We gotta be careful. Masilo family can steal. You're visiting a foreign country for the first time. Give me something you'd be worried about.
The transport system.
The transport system. Oh. Y'all been in the huddle thinking about
this? Yeah.
You've collectively come up with an answer?
Yeah.
Yes.
Should be the right one.
Pulling for you.
Yes. Yes.
If you were visiting a foreign country for the first time, name something you'd be worried about.
Steve, some countries have high criminal rates, so definitely safety.
Yeah, well done, well done. Well done. It's up there.
If y'all coming from South Africa, Johannesburg, and you worried about crime, where the hell y'all going? Worried about the crime? I thought that was a good answer. That was a good answer. That's the first thing I'm worried about. Number six. Five.
For you.
Yeah. Well, that was round three, everybody. Masilo family not on the board. Skeepers family, 324. Well, don't go away, because after the break, we're going to be doubling the points. You still got a chance. You're in good shape. Don't go away, y'all. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. Masilo family not on the board. Skeepers family 324. Woo! Give me Let's Say Ho and give me Savannah. Woo! All right, ladies, let's go. Listen, in this round, we've doubled the points. We've got the top six answers on the board. All right, listen carefully. Name something people shout at that cannot shout back.
The car.
Huh?
My vehicle, a car.
Oh. Yeah. The car.
Yes. Good answer. Good answer.
The TV. TV
the
screen.
TV.
Oh, yes.
Woo! Let's go. Let's go. Kyle, give me something people shout at but they can't shout back.
The dog.
The dog.
Yes!
Natalie, name something people shout at that cannot shout back.
When you're in a stadium and there's a game playing and you're shouting at them and they can't shout back in a game.
At the game! T, we got one strike, man. Name something people shout at that cannot shout back.
Scientists use them a lot. Computers.
A computer. Kirsty, only one strike. Give me something people shout at that cannot shout back.
When your phone is frustrating you, Steve.
Yep, it's not working.
When your phone is frustrating you. Savannah, only one strike. Something people shout at that cannot shout back.
The robot is red, and you want to go. The traffic light. Traffic light when it is red.
Oh, I
and you
want to
put foot.
I don't know what the hell she was talking about. The robot. I turned around. Where? The traffic light. Traffic light. That's a good answer. I would have never thought of that. Kyle, listen to me, man. We got one strike, but we only got one answer left. You can clear the board. Something people shout at that cannot shout back.
I'm gonna say tools. Mm. Like
tools. Well, we got two strikes now, Miss Natalie. We gotta be careful. Masilo family can steal. Give me something people shout at that cannot shout back.
I'll go for appliances.
Yeah. Appliances! That was a good answer. Family, I just want y'all to get some points. because you seem like such nice people, and I just want to come over here and meet y'all. But I ain't gonna be able to get over here if we don't get one of these answers now. So come on now. It's gonna be hard, because there's only one left. But we have another round. You are still in it. Name something people shout at that cannot shout back.
Steve, a baby, a child.
A baby!
Good answer.
We got some points! All right, here we go. Listen to me, folks. In the last round, because both of you have points, all of you now have everything to play for. Because whoever has the most points at the end of this round will be playing for the jackpot of 75,000 Rand. Well, folks, here's the situation. Masilo family 150, Skeepers family 324. Let's get it on. Give me y'all. Give me Kyle. Fellas, in this round, points are triple. Surveyed 100 people. Top five answers on the board. This is a fill in the blank. I love to eat fried what?
Fried chips.
Fried chips.
Fried chicken.
Fried chicken.
Yes.
We're gonna play.
I know. Miss Natalie? I love to eat fried what?
Steve, I'm gonna say fried fish.
I love fried fish. Fish!
Yes! Yes.
T, I'm gonna tell you something I've noticed.
Yes, sir.
Every time I come to you, you give me an answer that's on that board.
Mm. I try.
I know. It's a bright guy.
Thank you.
I love to eat fried what?
A tasty breakfast has to include some fried eggs.
Oh, yes. Woo.
Fried eggs.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Kirstie, there's only one answer on this board. If it's there, you clear the board. And if it's there, your family wins the game. And if it's there, your family will be playing for 75,000 Rand. Now that we've got that out the way, it's the last answer. It has the least amount of people who said it. Let's see if you can come up with it. I love to eat fried what?
Bacon, Steve.
Yes. Yes. From a vegan.
I love to eat fried bacon for the win. Oh. Savannah, one strike. If it's there, you clear the board, your family wins the game, you'll be playing for 75,000 Rand. If it's not there, you're still alive. I love to eat fried what?
Fried beef. I'm gonna go there.
This is for the win. Fried beef!
Come on, fried beef. I'm sorry.
Kyle, we are down to you, sir. If it is there, your family wins the game, Your family will be playing for 75,000 rand. But this time, Kyle, you have two strikes. If it's not there, the other team can steal and they can win the game. Kyle, I love to eat fried what?
Vegetables.
I love to eat fried vegetables. Well, family, I haven't been over here all day. But there's probably not a more important question than the one I'm about to ask you, because it's very simple now. We're going to triple these points. That will give you enough, if the answer's there, to win the game. And then you folks will be playing for 75,000 rand.
Wow. Woo. Woo. Who won that money? Come on, Chemoso.
If it is not there, the other family wins the game. One answer does it all. This is for all the marbles. Drum roll, please. Cut! Drum roll. Cut! Just wanted to see if it worked. Tomoso?
Mm-hmm.
Fill in the blank. I love to eat fried what?
Sausages. We call it Boris this side, but sausages.
You call it what?
Boris.
Sausages. This is for the win and all the marbles. Fried sausage! Number five. Well, hey man, y'all played good. Y'all made a comeback, you got close, you almost had it. But you don't go away empty-handed. We're gonna triple the points, and you're walking away with 7,500 rand. And we're gonna give you a year's worth of KFC to the value of 10,000 rand. Well done, everybody. Thank you, folks, for joining us. And thank all of our friends at KFC. Hey, SKEEPERS family, I need two of you. I need two of you. There you go. Get over there. We're going to play Fast Money. We're going to go. We're playing for the jackpot. 75,000 rand right after this. Welcome back to the Feud, everybody. The SKEEPERS family won the game. And now it's time to play
Fast Money.
All right, now, Natalie, here's how Fast Money works. Your son is off stage where he can't see or hear your answers. I'm gonna ask you five questions in 20 seconds. If you can't think of something, you just say pass. We have enough time left, we'll get back to it. But if you and your son together come up with 200 points, tell everybody what you're gonna win.
75,000 rand! Yes!
Miss Natalie, are you ready?
I'm ready.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Name something children consume a lot of at a birthday party.
Cake.
Something that is expensive to replace on a car.
Alternator.
A color in the South African flag.
Blue.
An occupation in a TV studio.
Producer.
Something you wear in winter.
A coat. Yes.
Well, let's see how we did, Miss Natalie. Here we go. Name something children consume a lot of at a birthday party. You said cake, survey said. Here we go. Something that's expensive to replace on the car. You said alternator. Survey said. a color in the South African flag. You said blue, survey said. An occupation in a TV studio, you said producer, survey said. All right. Something you wear in winter, you said coat, survey said. All right, let's go. Now, I made a mistake. When you were out there, I kept saying your son, if you and your son, I'd read it, is you're her nephew. So we got that cleared away. She did okay, she got 81 points. You need 119 to win. But they got the right dude out here, I can tell you that right now. We have a chance right now. I'm gonna ask you the same five questions. You cannot duplicate the answers. If you do, you're gonna hear this sound. I'm gonna say try again, you give me another answer. Gonna be a little bit tougher this time, so I'm gonna give you 25 seconds. You ready?
I'm ready.
All right, let's remind everybody of Natalie's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Name something children consume a lot of at a birthday party.
Cake.
Try again.
Sweets.
Something that is expensive to replace on a car.
Carburetor.
A color in the South African flag.
Green.
An occupation in a TV studio.
Cameraman.
Something you wear in winter.
Jacket.
All right, let's see how you did.
Okay.
All right, here we go. Name something children consume a lot of at a birthday party. You said sweets. Survey said cake. Cake was the number one answer. We need 93 points. Something that is expensive to replace on a car. You said carburetor. Survey said engine.
I mean,
engine. Yeah, you gotta replace the whole engine. Hell.
Yeah.
A color in the South African flag. You said green. Survey said. Okay. Red was the number one answer. Red. 68 points away. An occupation in a TV studio. You said cameraman, survey said. Producer. Producer was the number one answer. We need a big one. 48 points for 75,000 Rand. Something you wear in winter, you said. The jacket. Survey said. Jersey. Jersey was number one. Well done, SKEEPERS family. You scored 152 points. So we're gonna triple that. We're gonna add it to your earlier score. You're walking out of here with a family fortune of 52,500 Rand. I'm Steve Harvey. We'll see you next time, folks.